And let me show you a quick demo.
Draws diagram.
What I'm going to show you is a signal feeding an AND gate. And one signal is going to look like this.
Labels X.
And my signal Y is going to look like this.
Y below X.
Okay, so you expect a processed output. So the 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. And the output is simply going to be, this is my time axis going this way, is going to be a ANDing of these two signal values like so. What I'm also going to show you is I'm going to superimpose noise on this wire.
Zigzags on a smooth line.
I'm going to superimpose noise on the wire. And what I want you to observe is the output of this digital gate, is the output will stay exactly like this, even though I impose noise. The ultimate test. So stay right there. Let's do this demo. Give me a couple seconds.
Instructor leaves the lecture hall.
Try it.
Fade to black. Later, a cameraman is at the front of the room. The instructor and another man enter carrying chainsaws. They wear black suits and sunglasses. They begin a synchronized dance. The instructor puts his foot on the desk to hold down a metal case and presses the chainsaw to it. He looks at the projection screen on the side of the classroom. It displays three lines with different sizes. Squares off their forms. The middle line is jagged and vibrating when the chainsaw lands.
So if you look at the signal up there, look at the middle waveform, and I'm imposing, let's have a digital system in a noisy environment, like a lumber yard, for example, or, chopping a bunch of trees in my backyard, building digital systems on the side. And, if I have my buddies, revving up chainsaws, I'm superimposing noise on my second input, but look at the output. And just to know that, show that I'm not bluffing here, what I'll do is I'll pass the noise through and make the noise larger. And you'll notice that when the noise begins to surpass the noise margins, the output begins to go berserk. Watch. Can you increase it gradually?
The vibrations on the middle line become much more jagged.
So notice that as I put in a lot more noise, then the output begins to go berserk. But as long as my input is within the noise margin, my output stays perfectly stable. So that's the intro to digital systems. You'll see numbers in recitation, and we'll see you in lecture on Tuesday.